Hey everybody, welcome back to yet another First Look at Dino System. This time we are on update 0.4.1 Alpha. At the time of recording this and when this will be uploaded, it'll be one day from when this goes live on Steam. So if you're watching this more than a day after it's come out and you're interested in this game, would like to pick it up, I'll have a link in the description to the Steam page where you can get it. I'm the Dry Bread. I already did a video showing an early alpha of Dino System, but there have been three major patches that have come out since making that video, and I would read off the change logs for you guys, but each one of them is paragraphs and paragraphs and paragraphs. So I'm mostly going to be going into what's new as I go along. If you want to see that old one, I'll have it in the playlist in the description. But let's see everything that's new in Dino System. First of all, you can see that the UI has changed dramatically. You can, for instance, you can pick your starting season. For the sake of making this a bit easy to show things off, I'll start in spring, which is the easiest one, because you're not about to go freeze or anything. Island size and the fertility, initial fertility at least, I'm going to keep both as default. Fertility would be, you know, how quickly the animals breed, and the island size is, of course, just the island size. I don't want to see the map generation, and I don't need, you know what, I'll keep the tutorial on just in case. And we're on survival mode, of course. It's just going to generate the world real quick, and there's the same message as before, just letting you know that, no, the developers do not, in fact, believe that dinosaurs lived amongst humans. They're just on the process of making a plot that makes this make sense. Hasn't been implemented yet. Again, early alpha. But right after this loading screen, we'll be seeing the very first thing that is a huge, huge change from the previous version. Not this, picking between metric and imperial. Metric and UK/US. Pounds and Fahrenheit. That is an interesting way to put that. Versus grams and Celsius. Okay. Fun fact, the UK does not use Fahrenheit. Just thought I'd point that out. Again, it's an Italian team making the game, so I'm not sure if they're aware of that or not. But right. Also, pounds as in measurement, or like a measurement of weight, that'd be lumped in with imperial, I believe. But I could just be stupid and misremembering. Right, this is what I wanted to show you as a big new thing. Is we actually have a character creation thing here now. Here we have an allotted 100 points, and we can spend that on our initial skills. I believe before we just started with a 30 in every single skill, which can you replicate that now? You might have no, you don't have the points to replicate that anymore. Although you can get more points by dropping your skill in things. As you hover over these things, you can see there's an in-game tooltip for these, telling you what each thing is. But because I'm not terribly, this goes white as you can with brown hair, that's as close to me as you're gonna get. Because I'm not terribly skilled at this, I have not really tested this a whole lot, I'm just gonna go off what I think would be the best for a starting character, which I think for a starting character, the things you immediately want, a little bit of fire making. I don't think that is super vital, but some fire making is good. I definitely want some serious points in gathering, and these will go up as you continue to do tasks over and over. But failing to gather repeatedly in the early game is very frustrating, so I'm actually going to have a lot. Same with failing to craft, so I'm going to have some crafting, not quite as much. I don't care that much about butchering. I feel like that'll be kind of natural. I'd rather be able to survive on getting equipment and stuff like that first, finding fruit through gathering if I have to, and work my way up to hunting. Zoology lets you inspect animals, right? Different tiers of zoology will allow you to see different things about an animal. I'm not going to invest very much in that right now. I actually don't know how you build that skill up. I'm not gonna mess with my body fat or body muscle or metabolism. Each one has positives and negatives. We'll go over them real quick. Body fat, you're heavier and slower, but release energy to survive starvation. And remember, eating will make you fatter or more muscular. That is a thing that dynamically changes in the game. That's kind of one of the reasons why I don't want to invest too much in that early on. So fat makes you slower, but it helps keep you from starving. Muscle makes you heavier and less nutrition efficient, so you'll be burning up food less efficiently. However, you're stronger and more resilient, so you're harder to kill, better at hunting. Next thing I want is running speed and jump height goes up, as well as reducing chance to stumble. It's improved by running, which actually makes me not want to get it too much. What I kind of want is resilience, is your maximum health. It's also your resilience to temperature. So I want some points in that to help keep myself from just dying right away. Then, you know what? Knock that down a bit, have a little bit more endurance, and then I think we want melee skill. And the difficulties are casual and hardcore. On casual, you can respawn with a penalty. On hardcore, death is dying. Also, I believe that your skills decay. Yeah, your skills decay, whereas normally on casual, they don't. Let's do this! All right, my goal of the video is to show off a bunch about the game, for those of you who haven't seen it before. We'll bring this up, game pauses while you're in here. Is to show off a bunch of the game and hopefully kill a dinosaur, which we weren't able to do last time. So all you have to do is hit tab and you can see your basics and your controls and everything. I'll introduce them as I do them because I'm more familiar with them now. Lots of little updates have happened. You'll notice if you watch the previous video that everything looks much nicer. Mostly the trees, the grass, the ferns, everything. It looks nicer. He changed how they look, made them look better. And you'll see there's an in-game tooltip now, which means you can actually see it on the recording. I'm dry again. Now, when it says no luck, it tells me right here, but it means that you failed to gather. So you could succeed if you keep trying, but it looks like my chance on this tree is pretty low, even with my, oh no, there we go, even with my high gathering skill. All right, I can just hold left click to drag around now. It's really convenient, actually. The dragging has gotten a lot better in the game since the last update. See, our stomach is pretty full of solid food, which is good. We're pretty well full now. Our temperature is good. We have quite a bit of protein in our system, a lot of calories. They used to call it nutrition, now it's called calories. Our strength is okay, so let's start getting tools. So E is now a toggle. E for equip is a toggle now. It is no longer that obnoxious hold down system. And another fun thing, see, I have two things in my hand here. Let's go find another thing. There's a rock. I can drag it around despite having full hands, which is very useful. Oh shit. T-Rex. Okay, so what I did there, you saw how I moved the camera around. Also, I forgot to zoom out. You should always be zoomed out in this game, I think, so you can see just a little bit more. They've changed the viewing system. I can hold down right click, and it's a little bit fast. I hope there's an option to slow it down at some point if there isn't already. But you can look around with this. And what that does, it doesn't let you see forever. There is a point. See, it starts to get hazy and dark and can't see. Oh no, you know what? Might have been wrong. It might be you can't. Oh, is that supposed to be the asteroid that hit? Or, I don't know, there's something over there. I want to check it out. Right. Apparently you can see forever right now, which I'm a little bit confused about. It's entirely. Ooh, I stumbled. It's possible. Whoa, God, that is fast. It's possible that that is just for testing purposes. I don't know. Or that has gone up by a skill I have and I'm not aware. I don't know. What I want to find right now. And getting soaked, yeah. Now, if I'm able to, yeah, you can kind of drag with no free hand by going too quick. Oh, God! Holy shit, that was hidden! Well, my resilience went up. Jesus Christ! Oh, there's a few of them. Well, I dropped my gear. Okay, that dinosaur is probably not gonna kick my ass. You can hit F on the dinosaur when you see it to have it spotted. Yeah, he looks like he's fine. Okay, let's get under a tree. So the tree gives us half shelter. It's 50% cover from the rain. We're actually pretty thirsty. Or at least we have almost no liquid in us, so I'm gonna just drink a little bit of rain. There we go. Let's make sure we're hydrated. Okay, let's scout around a little bit. We're on day two. I want to find some rocks. There's a T-Rex. There's a pond. There's that thing. I'm gonna make my way over there. I want to find some more rocks to work with. I need to sharpen some rocks, gather some twigs, and see if I can make myself a stone axe. Oh, there's a stone. I'm bleeding. Nothing I can really do about that at the moment. Let's get under the tree while we do this. And I want to sharpen that. So we're just gonna keep bashing with our rock. What was our crafting skill again? 25? Okay, our crafting skill's not bad for this simple of a thing. Ooh, we have a branch over there. Let's just make sure that we got it close. Okay, so we've got a sharp stone there. I can reduce it, which will reduce it to a smaller size stone. Craft a stone axe. So we're just gonna make that with our sharpened big stone and our twig. I'm bleeding. I'm pretty sure you can make some kind of bandage. Maybe it's at a hide? Leaves? I'm not sure, actually. Well, we have our stone axe now. I'm soaked. I better find cover. Wetness, 100%. Okay, well, now we're under this tree. No fruit. Leaf? Don't know what I can do with a leaf. I think that was my guy stumbling there. Okay. Yeah, we need to sleep. Okay, we're gonna sleep under this tree here tonight. I'm bleeding. Yeah. We got really mauled by that thing. Staying well rested and well fed is probably good. Our health is slightly going up there, so that was good for us. Let's have our breakfast. Okay. I hear something moving. It's that thing. Okay. I want to go see what this thing over here is. Time to light a fire. Okay, well, if you insist. Now, to light a fire, I know previously you needed two rocks in your hands and then you needed something to burn. Get closer. I don't know if I could do it with something else, though. With what? Can't use my axe for it. I guess I wouldn't be able to make a spark. I need two stone things to bash together for that. Can't walk down into that thing. Time to light a fire. You know what? Starting to get daytime out. I think you'll survive, buddy. Oh, there's a fruit over there. And we're almost dry. So my big goal right now to find some stone. There's a rock. I'm just gonna run over to that one. I don't know why that running icon always flickers like that. I'm always confused by that. Okay, let's test this. Is this? Oh. I want to see if having one in each hand, with one of them being. Ah, doesn't count. Okay. That's a bit weird to me. That having the stone axe wouldn't count as having a stone for the sake of making a spark, considering it is made of stone. Okay, there's some rocks over there. You should take a nap. We're just gonna make our way over here. So, if we want to kill something, we do, a bow would be nice. However, we can't make a bow without a tendon. Come on, I want more than one stick. We can't make a bow without a tendon. We can't get a tendon without killing something. Get closer. A little bit afraid of standing in the fire. Need more fuel to light a proper fire. Well, it'll be something. You know, I probably should have saved it for nighttime, but. Oh! Oh, that was me stumbling. Well, hope that doesn't spread to the tree. I'm gonna drop both of those rocks here. This is gonna be our little de facto camp area for now. Don't need to be completely nomadic. And we'll sleep over here. And the tree is catching on fire. Immediately proving that to be a bad idea. So, I'm just gonna back off, and I think I just started a wildfire. Have a little bit of water. And maybe you'll take a nap in the pond. Can't sleep on water. Damn! My fireproofing plan didn't work. I hope I don't wake up on fire. Come on. Wish me luck. Millie's wishing me luck. That's one of my cats. All right, come on. All right. All right, back in a sec. Oh no. Okay, back in a second. Gonna take care of a meowing cat. Problem solved, although the problem of the raging wildfire has not been solved. Oh my god. And you see, little lesson to myself right there. What I did was a bad idea. Don't start a fire under a tree. And as we walk around and try and find a way out of this horrible situation, wow, I am boiling to death. I need to get away from that. I'm gonna show you a magic trick. So because I now live in a one-room apartment, I actually have no way of keeping cats out of the room when I want to record. Oh, I should take a nap, should I? It's too bright over here to take a nap. And so all I had to do was put said Millie cat on my lap. So I have a magic trick. You will only hear the cat when I say Millie. Oh shit, magic trick didn't work. She didn't make a noise this time. Anyway, yeah, we should take. Where is it? I want to take a nap, but there's a T-Rex looking right at me. God damn it, and this way's a wildfire. Okay, we're going to the beach. Day trip. So we're in a pretty shit situation right now. I blame myself. But on the upside, we're decently well fed. We could use some more liquid and solid food, I'm sure, but we're not in the danger zone, Kenny Loggins may say. The forest fire has, oh no, the forest fire is as bad as ever, okay. I was hoping the rain might help die it down, but it's a pretty intense fire. A little bit of rain's not gonna do much. Unless we get like a proper rainstorm going. And I'm getting soaked. Is that? No, that's spoiled. That one's fine. Never mind, it's not fine. I just couldn't tell from that distance. Okay, it's quite the situation we've got going right now. I think I'm just gonna sleep under this tree. It's too cold to sleep. Wait, did it say it's cold to sleep? It's cold to sleep. That is, again, a byproduct of the development team not having English as a first language. Shit happens sometimes. It should be, it's too cold to sleep. Although, use the correct its, so you get points on with me for that. Most native English speakers don't get that right. All right, let's go ahead and start a fire here. I think it's far enough from the tree that we can safely say I'll be okay. Whoa, I stumbled and fell on it. It's wet. God damn it. Well, I don't have the option of making it under the tree, buddy. Oh, that time I said it's too cold to sleep. We're in a bad way right now. Where's the wind coming from? That way? I'm gonna stand on this side of the tree trunk then. Maybe I could grab some fruit. Ooh. Yeah. Hey, while I'm at it, I should get some water. So I stumbled drinking that water. Really took me off guard. Now, by my understanding, the more tired I get, the more likely I am to just be able to fall asleep despite bad conditions for sleeping. My strength is at 50%, which is quite bad. And that's all the fruit in that tree, but hey, at least it's something. You know what? Let's go a little bit more into this denser part of the trees. I bet you the rains or the wind is a little bit more blocked by the trees over here. In fact, if I go under both of those trees. Oh no, that does not give me a combined bonus. Damn. Well, it's a tough game. Oh, no, we're willing to sleep now. Okay. We're pretty exhausted. Our stamina is awful right now. Maybe when we wake up, it'll be a little bit warmer. It was a few degrees warmer. It's telling me Fahrenheit? That's weird. I thought I had it set to Celsius. I must have mistakenly left it on the US-UK one. I actually don't know Fahrenheit at all. I'm Canadian, so I know Celsius. Spoiled. That one doesn't look spoiled. Are any of these, That one's good. You're full? Okay, well, that's always good. Our nutrition is going up. Our hydration is going up. Okay. It's just, no luck? Okay. Shit, we barely slept. I don't know how we're gonna deal with this storm. What could we craft? There's an idea. Well, a bedroll would keep us warm, wouldn't it? We need leaves and pelts. Well, we're gonna have to hunt to get pelts. We need a spear. Useful for chopping trees and butchering carcasses, or as a cheap weapon. So a better weapon. Oh, we're so cold we're taking damage. A better weapon would be a stone spear. We need a small, sharp stone and two branches. We are passing out right now. I'm just gonna tell my guy manually to sleep again because it's getting a little bit warmer. Again, I don't know how warm 40 Fahrenheit is. I think freezing in Fahrenheit is like 32, so it's gotta be pretty cold. And our dude is naked. We haven't made clothing yet. So we are really slumming it. Oh no, temperature's going back up. Okay, we're managing to get quite a bit of sleep here, actually. We're gonna wake up very refreshed. And the occasional pigeon cooing is my cat, not the video game, if you're wondering. And we got breakfast right here. Yeah, both of them are good too. Wow. That's a nice change of pace. The dinosaur gods look upon us favorably today. Okay. We're actually doing okay. It's not raining. The wind has died down a bit. We've got food and water. We have an axe for butchering. I think, and therefore I am, ready to make a spear. Can I do it a fern? I can get a leaf. Okay, I don't need that till I make a bedroll. Okay. We have some stones here. Gotta keep that in mind. Hi, bird. Right, I'm gonna sharpen it and then I'm gonna whittle it down. Gotta keep in mind that I got some stones here for starting fires. That was me stumbling again. I am not the most graceful man on earth. My athletics is very low. I can just trip on my own two feet sometimes. Okay. So here's the stone we want. I'll equip that just so I can carry it. We need to get two branches from a tree, which shouldn't be hard. We've got quite a few trees over here. In fact, we have quite a few branches over here. But I think I'll leave those branches. Oh, I already had a stone over here. I'll leave those branches for now just for making a fire later. We need two branches. And let's go ahead and craft ourselves a stone spear. Man, the days really do go by fast in this game. Then again, you're always occupied. That's one thing that I really like. You always feel like you've got something to work on. Okay, so we now have a spear. Why we're holding it from the very end like that, I don't know. It's a little bit comical to me. Can't imagine you'd have a very good grip, but enough of me criticizing for no reason. We have a spear. And an apple that we have eaten. Or some kind of fruit. I think this is going to be our camp. We're going to designate this as our camp. So what I want to do, we're just going to... Can't put it on our back. Okay, well... Let's just have the spear sitting under the tree here. We're gonna equip our two stones. These are our fire-making stones. It's wet. Light it beneath a roof or a tree. I learned my lesson on that one cheeky game. Don't know why I hold the spear backwards in that hand. I guess my guy's a lefty. I should carry some of this charcoal over for the sake of starting fires, though. I imagine that's probably a good idea. So that charcoal's gonna sit over there now. Alright, let's see if we can nap. It's cold to sleep. Okay. Well, as a solution to it being cold, I am going to will myself into being fatter and hope that that counts as insulation. However, because I don't think I can gain weight through sheer willpower, maybe I should take this opportunity to hunt. You know, if I'm going to scud around like that, I should do it while I'm under a tree. Day 7. Man, we don't sleep often, do we? So what do we see in the world today? Not dinosaurs, apparently. Oh, there's one. It's by some rocks. Maybe I want to make my way down there. Yeah, I think I want to live around here. This looks like a much better zone. Okay. And I do like that the camera doesn't teleport back to you. It sweeps across the world back over to you. Because when it sweeps across the world to you, that allows me to re-get my bearings on exactly where I am in relation to it. And so, of course, I know that if I keep walking this way, I'll get there. Let's actually run a little bit. We've got no shortage of food. And I want to get my athletics up faster, and it seems like running does that much faster. Wouldn't want to start stumbling while running away from something scary. And I believe regaining our breath like this... regaining the breath is, that's a T-Rex. That'll hopefully kick the ass of one of those things, then wander off so I can skin it. Okay. Okay, it's wandering over there a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna go over this way. Sorry, I got distracted. I believe getting my breath back helps with endurance? I'm gonna say endurance until I prove myself otherwise. How close is it? It's going in the other direction. So I think I'm somewhat safe to sleep. It is warmer than before, although still very cold. I think that's the equivalent of maybe 8 Celsius, maybe 10. It looks like it's going down a little bit as well. Also, the cat is getting cooey and meowy again, so we're gonna take another short break from this wonderful session, yes. From this wonderful session. We're back again. So, we have these beautiful dinosaurs wandering towards us, Triceratops. They are apparently- this one's hurt. Okay. Now, here's the thing. I'm afraid that that one is gonna kick my ass if I try and kick this one's ass. I'm also more than a little afraid that it's going to just kill me. Alright, I need to stand right here. What I could do is make multiple spears and start picking them up and throwing them. But my ranged skill sucks. I'm better at melee. Then it'd be quite tedious to try and get a bunch of spears. Although, I do have a lot of trees for branches, and we do have those boulders over there. So, I might be able to pull it off. If it weren't raining right now, I'd start a campfire. Day 8. We are tired as well. Let's try a nap again. We're close to summer. Good. Need some hotter weather. Seasons do go by fast. Looks like it's 9 or 10 days to a season. Our health is up quite a bit. Still haven't fully recovered from our mauling earlier in the game. What the heck? Oh, because I got pushed. Can't tell if it's healing or not. Ooh, fresh fruit. Thank you, dinosaur gods, for breakfast. Let's go ahead and the rain is very light now, so let's just have a drink from this puddle. And we're good for nutrition. That's going up. That is a Triceratops. Oh, yeah. Just a Triceratops. For a second I was thinking Tyrannosaurus Rex. That's a much bigger one. This one's small. I want to kick this one's ass. Oh, I get zoology just by examining it and watching it for long enough. That's interesting. I should attack it during the night while they're asleep. Like, that one's asleep right now. Maybe I should strike right now. Okay, let's remind ourselves on how to fight here. Cleaning pelt. Actually, a pelt is obtained from an animal carcass. Right-click it, cut pelt. Sharp stone requires you to craft clothing and other items or basic cloth itself, but first you need to clean it. Wield a sharp stone, get very close to the raw pelt on the ground, right-click it and clean it. It's sped up by butchering skill and your general strength. Okay, so I'm scraping it to get all the meat and sinew off. Okay. We want to fight, so let's X to attack, one click for melee, two clicks for range. That is different from how it used to be with the new targeting system. I actually prefer this new one. I don't know if X is the key I like most for it. Let's just swing while we're back here, just for an example. And that's our cooldown bar there. That's what I heard. What's it doing? It's charging down here. Did it see an animal it wants to eat? It's chasing them down. Well, that means it's far away from me. So now's my time to strike. I'm gonna attack from behind. Eh! Don't you run away from me. Shit, there's one behind me. Oh, I accidentally threw it. Hey, hey, hey! Shit, ow. Don't make me. It's not as good of a weapon, actually. My spear was better. That's... gave up? I guess it decided it defended its young. I'm guessing that's what that was. Damn it. Well, I'm gonna keep walking after it. Although I am wounded now. Need to stay fed. Again, it's like I talked about in the previous video. Humans were good hunters. Ooh, for a few reasons, historically. One, we could raise our arms above our heads, meaning that we could throw things overhead. Which hurt things quite a bit when you throw a rock from over your head. I don't know where the thing ran off to. The other big thing is that we were good at persistence hunting. We were one of the slower things. We couldn't outrun most animals that we hunted. However, We had more stamina than they did. We could outrun them. Looking for food. That is another Triceratops. Neither of them are wounded, so neither of them are the ones I was fighting. And I'm still bleeding. God damn. Oh, here's my boulder area again. That one's very slightly wounded. I'm not gonna be able to attack them when they're all herded together like this. So I've still never successfully killed my first animal. I don't think I need to find a stone right now. There's plenty laying around on the ground. It's too young. We should probably get some sticks. Just have them ready for whatever we need them for. Maybe a quick campfire or anything. And plus, it gets me gathering skill to keep gathering like this, and that'll help me gather fruit in desperate times. I do definitely think that if you're going to set up, setting up in a forest is nice. Easy source of fruit for early on, easy branches. If you can find a forest with a boulder like this, that's great, because then you can easily find stone as well. Although, it does make it harder to spot the animals nearby. You can get something can sneak up on you, like I got snuck up on by that T-Rex earlier. Oh, like that T-Rex. I'm just gonna keep walking. Oh, come on! Probably smells my blood. This might be it for me. Run through the other ones. I don't think it's gonna chase me. Oh Jesus, there's one up there too. Oh come on, why did he pick me? Those guys are way meatier than I am. Oh, this is gonna be the death blow. Okay. Just gonna have a little snack and have a little sleep and hope we don't get killed in our sleep. I don't know what happened there. Did the Triceratops chase it off? Our strength is bad. I mostly blame the critical health. We are damn near on our deathbed. Luckily, it's early summer, so we don't need to worry about being woken up by the cold very much. And it looks like, sleep-wise, we're doing great. Bleeding-wise, yeesh. I don't think there's anything we can do to, like, bandage ourselves up is the thing. We just gotta... Ooh. Just gotta make sure that we're fed, we've rested, all that good stuff. See if you can get some fresh fruit, buddy. Come on. Oh. Oh, my bleeding went down to 20%. So this must be working. God, I wish I could get some meat. Alright, get another branch. We need to go get a stone. There's one. Luckily, there's a tree right here, so we can actually gather stones well in shade. Is that stone on the ground there? Okay. Bleeding is still 20%. Okay. Just gonna sharpen the stone, see if we can make ourselves a new spear. We handled that last one badly, but it was mostly a problem thanks to some inconvenient timing with T-Rexes. Also, it's warm. We are in the shade under this tree, though. I'm bleeding. Now, I don't know if bleeding can kill you or not. I think you had to get killed by an actual attack, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm bleeding. Okay, I might as well just sleep again. I need rest. I'm really wounded. I'm dry again. That's nice. Either than, you know, being wet with blood. and is cooling off for the night, so that's nice. I believe when the temperature is green like that, that might mean it's comfortable. That is a baby Tyrannosaurus. Is it so young that I could wreck it? Not at this health, I can't. Probably not, at least. I would imagine not. No bag equipped. I'm naked, carrying nothing. Okay, so I can make some kind of bag at some point, which I'd very much like. Got my spear, I've got my axe. Anything here not spoiled? That one's not spoiled. And the bleeding has stopped, so we are regenerating health now, albeit slowly. That looks like an adult. Elkiosaurus. Or Ankiosaurus. Ankylosaurus. Ankylosaurus. I'm illiterate. So I'm really worried at this point. Oh, my guy's sweating. That's probably not good. Get under the shade. Okay. Easy to sleep during the summer. I've taken note of that, and that's good. It's very easy to sleep during the summer, in fact. What I'm concerned about... what I'm concerned about is dying of my horrible wounds before I can get them healed. They're healing very slowly, and I don't believe there's a faster way to heal them either than just being well-fed. Thing is, we never really get our nutrition above this point here, because I believe you would need cooked meat for that. Actual cooked meat has a lot of protein in it. We're working mostly off calories. You don't get much protein from these fruit. So really, we need to be eating better food. To do that, we need to kill, and to kill, we need health. Or very good tactics. And I think we know which one's going to happen first, which is health. Pelt cape. Keeps you warm somewhat. We need a tendon for a bow, a branch we can easily do. We already have the crafting. The only thing we don't have the crafting for is a sleeping, or a bedroll. However, that wouldn't be hard to get 2 extra points. So I'm not overly concerned about that. Now, for my game plan, I'm thinking I eat one more fruit before bed. I feel so weak. My strength is very bad. Yeah, let's go get the water. Speaking of, I'm actually quite thirsty. Our body muscle has not gone down much. Our body fat has not gone down much. Our metabolism has. However, because our fat and muscle haven't gone down much, that tells me that I've done a pretty good job. I feel bloated. Okay. I've done a stop complaining. Nap more. I've done a pretty good job, I think, of staying fed. We've been sticking pretty much to forested areas, so it's easy to find fruit. You, sir, are an asshole. I'm going back to sleep. That's what I get for sleeping by the watering hole. Yeah! Really want to be rested. See, my strength is above 50 now. In fact, it's almost at 60. We gained some weight. Hopefully healthy weight. And our health is above that tick there, which is a good sign. Not thirsty. Okay, good to know. Our nutrition is almost at that final tick. And I'm bloated again, but hey, trying to stay fed. Now I'm trying to think if there's any kind of clever way I could kill these things. Maybe I mismade my character and I should have had more melee. Or maybe more muscle, even. Not entirely sure. Having more athletics would have been nice, because I did have to chase the thing. Where is it? is. I'm gonna go around the other dinosaurs and stay far, far away. I'm full. Good. I'm in a sandstorm. The shade feels nice. Sorry, I just really like reading those out. They're funny to me. I'm in a sandstorm. Okay, the wind's coming from that way, so I'm gonna stand right here. So, sandstorms suck. I haven't been in one before, but I would imagine what it does is it makes me very dehydrated. Am I misreading this? Would standing here help more? No. Don't know if I need to be reminded constantly that I'm in a sandstorm. Think maybe that's a tooltip that needs to be toned down a little bit. But hey, Alpha, shit happens sometimes. Okay, so just getting my bearings, we're back here by the boulders. The Tyrannosaurus Rex is still over there, and it ate something. There's a carcass. And I, as the good hunter that I am, need to prey on that carcass. So we're gonna have our axe out, and we're gonna see if we can work our way over there and wait for the guy to wander off. And we cut up the body, and we get ourselves a tendon, maybe some hide. Maybe we can make clothing with it. Okay, is it still there? Of course it is. It is hurt, though. And sleeping. I really should have something targeted whenever I can, just for the sake of getting my zoology skill up. It seems like zoology might be an easy skill to get. Okay, just, Yeah, get a tendon. Nice and quiet. Yes! Axe broke getting a tendon! God damn it. Alright. Alright, we already have a branch over there. Ooh. Okay, well, we got a tendon. We need to find a large stone. Gonna hang out by the other dinosaurs. Be safe. Right, we need to find a large stone. Actually, we need two stones. One to carve a, and then one to use for our axe. Because I don't want that corpse going to rot. There are two of them and they're coming this way. Looking for food. Well, I don't want to be that food. Stop stumbling. Okay. There's a large stone. Sharpen it. I don't think I want to take a nap right now with these Tyrannosaurus Rexes wandering around. Okay. Okay. Things are coming up, Millhouse. Don't know why the tendon can only be in that hand. Guess it's because that's my non-using item hand. We're gonna go ahead and craft ourselves a new stone axe. Are we in the shade? We're in the shade, good. And I don't hear T-Rexes walking around. We feel weak. Probably sleep and heat, I would imagine, because nutrition-wise, we're still doing decently. Although we could definitely need some- we could definitely use some more water. Oh, we still have tendons left. Right, I didn't use it yet. What am I thinking? Okay, the body. Shit. It really decayed that fast? Okay. Okay, we can work with this. Okay, this is looking up. We're crafting our first bow. I've never used a bow in this game before. I don't know what I shoot, actually. Probably... rocks? Can I make arrows? I actually don't know. I hope I can. I don't think maybe we sharpen sticks with a sharp stone. Shoot that. Oh, create this faster. Create this faster. Something's coming. I don't want to fight it. It's going the other way. Okay. God damn it. Okay, drop the axe for now. So there's a baby right there I could kill. Don't take that out of context. Shit. That's what you get for being on the internet. Yeah, I could kill that. But I feel like its parents will probably wake up and kick my ass. My health still isn't great, it's just not critical anymore. Just sleep, dude. Just sleep. I know, you're next to a pile of shit. Probably shouldn't have done that, but whatever, deal with it. You're living amongst dinosaurs. You don't have the greatest life anyway. And the temperatures are getting brutal. Ooh, our health is going up a lot now, though. Sleeping really does help you heal. No arrows. Okay. Stone arrows. A sharp stone, a branch, and a leaf. I'm guessing that's per arrow. So we're gonna leave this axe there for now. Moist dung. Gonna just move that out. Okay. So our big goal now. Oh, not thirsty. Our big goal now. We're gonna sharpen some stones, make some arrows. We haven't made a quiver yet, which might get in the way. Was hoping we could cut up that hide and get something out of that, but that did not come to fruition. So we're just gonna do what we can. And once again, the rain is a pain in the ass, but we've just got to deal with it. You're slightly isolated from the wind here. Probably a good thing. Okay. So we've got the stone, we've got the branch, we can grab a leaf. Just gotta sharpen it because I think we broke the last one. Got our crafting to 30, nice. So there's nothing we can't craft now. At least in this version of the game. Now we just need to eat. No! Ah, God, I was trying to click the tree. Damn it. Now we can craft stone arrow. I think this just makes one. It says stone arrows, plural, so maybe I'm making more than one. Stone arrows crafted. Stone arrow, damn it. Well. Do I need to double click? Yeah, you double click as his ranged attack, and then I can retrieve the arrow. And we do still have our spear on our back. And what was the button for switching C to sheath and unsheath weapons? Okay, so that'll let us quickly switch. Fleeing. Oh, right, because me. I'm probably scary looking. God, I need a quiver. Need hide for that. Okay. We find something to kill. Our next kill attempt, because we've been going for a long time, our next kill attempt, I think, will be our last one for this video. Because this has quickly gone from, hey everybody, this is what this game is, to, God, I just want to kill something. And don't take that out of context either. So, our old spear is back there in case we need to run and grab something. Okay. What are we killing? I think they're all down there because that's where the water is. You know what? You might actually be thirsty right now. Come on. Okay. I'm attacking one of the babies. I'm that awful. Let's do it! Did I hit? I think I hit. Yeah! It's not very fast either. Hope you aren't his parents. Nope, apparently not. Good. I've almost got it, I've almost got it. I did it! Oh my god, I did it. I need the pelt, right? I need a sharp stone. And an axe. Oh god. I need to get one before it rots. We know it rots way too fast. Okay, okay, we need to work fast here. It's warm. I don't care if it's warm. And don't get tired. Okay, sharpen it, sharpen it, sharpen it. We need to not lose this pelt. We need to go get our bow back later, too, because I dropped it in my haste. Come on. Making the axe. I might even get some meat to cook out of this and get some more protein in the system. Oh, come on, now's not the time. Now's not the time, Tyrannosaurus Rex. Fuck you. Fuck you. Really? God damn it. We finally killed it. And it ate our goddamn hide. Alright, that's it for this video. Anyways, if you're interested in this game, and you want to keep up with it, and its development, all the information on it is in the description, as well as the Steam store page where you can go buy the game. I'm going to be doing a series on this game as it develops, because I think this game is super cool. So I'll both have a playlist in the description for my videos on this game, if you want to see more of me playing this game in the future, as well as a video on first looks in general from me. If you like the video, give it a like. If you like me, give me a subscribe, and until next time, have a nice day.